Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Tech Edu Information, Knowledge is Life. In this video, we are going to see implementation of DDA line drawing algorithm. Already we have seen how this DDA line drawing algorithm is working. I will share the link of the same in description box. So let us start. So first of all, the first step will be start. We need to declare required variables to perform this algorithm. So for that purpose, we are having x, y, x1, y1, x2, y2, k, dx, dy, s, xi, yi, and also we need to declare graphics driver and graphics mode. So in these variables, dx and dy will be differential of x and differential of y, s will be the number of steps, xi, yi, the values of x and y incremented, and x1, y1 will be the starting point of our line, x2, y2 will be the ending points of our line. And x and y we need to consider as the initial points of our line. Or how we are going to solve this mathematically to draw our line on our screen. Let us start with step by step. So after that, second step will be we need to initialize the graph mode with the path location in Turbo C. So that can be done with the help of initGraph method, which will tell we have to use three parameters: address of GD, that is graphics driver, address of GM, that is graphics mode, and then we have to tell the path of VGM. So initGraph will initializes the graphics system by loading the graphic driver from disk or validating or register driver and putting the system into graphs mode. So you can also tell initGraph to use the particular graphics driver and graphics mode, or to auto detect the attached video adapter at runtime and pick the corresponding driver. After that, we need to take the input of two lines, two line endpoints, and we need to store in the left endpoint, that is x1 and y1. So for that purpose, we need to consider x1, y1 value, and that we have to plot as a left end of or starting end of that line, and we have to trace that line by calculating or finding the next points by up to x2, y2, that is the second points. Then we have to start with loading x and y into the frame buffer that is used to plot the first point of that line. So we need to consider x1 as a x and y1 as a y1, and we have to plot these lines on our computer screen as a xy as a first point of our line. Then we have to calculate our differential of x and differential of y, and that can be calculated with the help of x2 minus x1, dx will be obtained, and for dy we will subtract y1 from y2. So we need to fetch all the values from our frame buffer, and we have to calculate this to find out the differential of x and differential of y. After that, we need to find out the absolute values of differential of x and differential of y to find out the number of steps. So absolute value calculation procedure already told in our DDA line drawing algorithm, so you can check it out. And if we need to pass out one condition, if the absolute value of dx is greater than absolute value of dy, if this condition is satisfied, so at that time we are having number of steps is equal to absolute value of dx. Otherwise, we need to get the absolute value of dy as a number of steps. So then we will calculate our next step to find out the incremented value of xi and yi respectively by performing the differential of x divided by number of steps and the differential of y divided by number of steps to find out x and y respectively. So in this way we will find out the required mathematical formula. The next thing, how we are going to find out the incremented values of our line. So for that purpose, k we are using, we need to start with k as a 0, and we have to increment that k value until we are reaching to the s. So until we are having k less than s, so we need to increment our x value by xi and y value by yi. So we will place all the values in our table. so we can get the incremented value. So we will increase this table further more, so until we will have the k value which is less than s. So this will be the main task in this algorithm. After that, we will plot our pixels calculated using putPixel function and with a specifying color. Then we will have perform closeGraph function and we will stop. So here is the program. So we need to include header files. Then we will call function for finding the absolute values of dx and dy, and that can be calculated with the help of this formula. And we will call our DDA line drawing function. So we will call it as a void DDA with the four parameters. X0, Y0 will be the starting points of our line. X1, Y1 will be the ending points of our line. So by considering these points, we will calculate differential of X and differential of Y. As I told you, we need to subtract from second point, first point from second point. And in this way, we will have our dx and dy. Then we need to find out the steps, and that can be calculated with the help of this formula or conditional operator we are using here to find out the steps. So if the absolute value of dx is greater than dy, then we will have this number of steps value will be absolute of dx, otherwise absolute of dy will be the steps count. Then we will find out the increment in x and y with the help of formula dx by number of steps and dy by number of steps to find out x inc and y inc respectively. Then we will start plotting our first point. By using loop, we will call our increment in x and increment in y. We will provide the delay to find out how it is going to be represented in our on our screen. Then this will be the DDA function, and we need to call with our graph main method. Then in that we will call our graphics driver and the graphics mode with initGraph method. After that, we need to tell compiler what are the starting and ending points of our line. So that we will call here at by declaring the variable integer x0 is equal to 2, y0 is equal to 2, and x1 is equal to 14, and y1 is equal to 16. So in function we will pass these values. When compiler reaches to this statement or function, it will directly jump to this function to execute the logical part, considering these are the starting and ending coordinates of our line. So this will be the end of our function, or you can say main method, with the help of getCH and closeGraph. And let us see how it is going to run this example, or how it is going to execute this program. Okay, so already I have typed whole program. Now we need to execute it. Let us check it. This program is going to run in code blocks. And if you want to set up code blocks with for running graphics program, you can check that video is also present in playlist. I will send the same link in description box also. So let us execute. We have given all the values required for drawing line. So that is also included here. Red line is displaying here. So this is the implementation of our DDA line drawing algorithm. In this way, it is going to plot line on our screen.